What's up, guys? Iván Carranza here, and today we're taking a look at the Sandberg California VM4. This particular bass has an alter body with a beautiful high gloss gold finish. It's got a Canadian hard rock maple neck with a maple fingerboard and also front dot inlays. It's got 22 frets, and this is a 34-inch scale bass. You can also get it as a 35 or 34-inch scale version for the 5-string models. It's got Sandberg's own pickups, which is the split call on the neck position and the Music Man style on the bridge position. It's got Sandberg's own preamp, which is push-pull on the master volume for active-passive mode switching. It's got a blend control, a treble boost and cut, which also works as a passive tone control on passive mode. That's pretty handy. And a bass boost and cut. It also has Sandberg's own hardware, which is the bridge, the ultralight tuners, and also the knobs on the bass. I think that's enough talking. Let's go straight on to the samples.
Thank you.
After listening to the examples, I'm sure you could hear that there are a lot of usable tones on this bass. And one thing that I'm really liking so far is the reverse split call pickup, which gives the lower strings some more clarity, some more definition, and also the treble strings more roundness. So that really makes the bass, you know, really punchy. Another combination that I'm really liking is the Music Man style pickup with the preamp engage, you know, boosting bass and treble. That makes it really like upfront, really aggressive, and that's something that I'm really liking so far. Another thing that I'm really liking is the neck profile, which is a C neck profile, and it's not too chunky or too thin either, so it just sits well in my hand. And also the nut width is kind of in between what would be a B bass and a jazz bass, so it's not too wide or too thin or narrow. So it's just, you know, Sandberg did a great job on that. I think it's just really comfortable. If you would like to know more about these basses, I would encourage you to go to sandbergguitars.de. You can also configure your own bass over there, and it shows an approximate of how much it would end up costing. I hope you guys liked the video. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Take care.